Bonjour et bienvenue. Imi Radio.
Okay, hello Warsaw. Hello.
Hello Warsaw, this is Virgil Smith. And to my right is Mr. Daedalus Chaos.
Daedalus Chaos, hi world.
Today in the studio here at What Keeps You Here at IMI Radio. And we have a very special guest today. His name is Pastilan Jay.
Oh yeah, thanks for having me here guys.
Thank you, man. Nice to have you in the studio. We, Pastilan is a singer and a composer, and you just did a show, am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, tell us
really?
About it.
Yeah, did Get Lead Festival last Thursday, I think, yeah?
Yes, was it Thursday the 10th,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, it was great. It's a successful festival, and it was my first time to play with my own songs only, not covers. My first time.
Oh, that's sweet. And we have a very, very treat for you today too, because Pastilan said he's going to perform for us live here in the studio.
Ooh,
so
excited.
If you missed the Get Lit Festival, you could hear some of the music here.
Sure,
thank you, man. So Pastilan, tell us a little bit about your background. Where are you from? How did you get here?
Well, I'm from the island called Mindanao, southern Philippines.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And since I was a kid, my mother taught me how to sing, but I was bad singer. It's like, oh, I will not sing. And later on, when I was 17, my brother told me to hold the guitar. And I was like, I don't know how to play guitar.
Uh-huh.
And he told me, then practice how to play guitar. I was like, okay, that's a good idea. And later on, after 2 years, I was trying to play with the band. And after that, I have a lot of connections with the band, with the other bands playing covers. And later on, 2010, I think, someone called me and was like, oh, let's go to Bangkok. It's cool there. I was like, okay. So we moved to Bangkok.
How far is Bangkok from where you were?
I was like, I don't know, 3 hours flight from the Philippines, I can't say.
Oh, okay. All right, so it wasn't like just a little trip. You were going far away.
And my mother was like, oh, be careful there. Yeah. And after that, we were playing with the band, and later on, I was like, it was cool, yeah?
Yeah.
And I met my wife, and we lived together there for 6 years, and she pushed me to play solo because she told me I can sing. I was like, really? I was like, yeah, believe in yourself. So I was, that's it, yeah. And
very nice. That's a very nice story. I want to go back to what you said. One of the first things you said, hey, one of the first things you said was that your mother taught you how to sing.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. What are some of the things she told you?
She told me to practice. Actually, she's not a good singer. No, she's she's the one who's giving me the confidence to do it.
Mm-hmm.
My sister, she's a very great singer, yeah?
Yeah.
And I was like, crap, piece of crap. Because I was scared all the time. I was like, I cannot do it. And
stage fright?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. And my father, he's not a good, like, to push you to do it.
Uh-huh.
He will tell you, like, oh, that's bad. So I feel like...
So he would be the one to say, you know what, you suck.
Yeah. Kind of.
He was just a straight shooter.
Shooter, like, my God, stop singing. I want to jump forward again. We have Pastilan's wife in the studio. Hi.
Hello.
She's sitting here observing. If you're watching us on Facebook, you could see her Facebook Live right now.
And if you Facebook watchers, you can also listen to us on www.meradio.pl. You don't need to just stick to Facebook.
That's true. Thank you, DJ. Yeah. That's a very good point. Because sometimes our volume on Facebook is not very loud, I'm
true.
Told.
Or the sync is off.
That's it. So you do have to go to www.imiradio.pl. And we're going to come back to our special guest in the studio, Pastilan. So you were in Bangkok. You were performing.
Yes.
Yeah. And you decided to leave Bangkok.
Yes, sir.
Why?
My wife wanted to go back to Warsaw. Uh-huh. So that's the main reason why we moved here. And I'm expecting, like, here, maybe it's like more opportunities for me than Bangkok, yeah.
To sing.
To sing, yeah.
And to make a living as a performer.
Yeah, I think so.
Very good. So you do like to do live shows and sing your music.
Yes.
Would you like to perform something for us?
Yes,
right
sure.
Now?
Yeah, sure.
That would be great. What would be your first song?
This will be a song called Beautiful Eyes.
Beautiful.
And it was, I wrote it when back in Bangkok. It's like a guy fall in love with beautiful lady, yeah, but mm-hmm. the lady she doesn't like him or something like that. So like, bye bye.
Okay. Beautiful Eyes, it's called. All right.
Cool. So whenever you're ready, go ahead and grab your guitar.
Okay.
Yeah, then we would love to see what you got.
Okay. Pastilan has his guitar for us, and he's going to sing something called one of his original songs called Beautiful Eyes. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
All right.
I recorded this song back in 2014 in Warsaw. I forget the studio name, though.
Wait.
We're trying to set up a recording for you so that you have it. And let's see. Here we go.
Are we live on Facebook?
We are live. We're starting it up now. And yes, we are live.
This song called Beautiful Eyes. I want to walk natural. I want to share what you've done to me. And I want you to understand. That's what I've got and that's all I have. I know you'd come and go, just passing like it same goes by. I just sit here and smile, waiting for another day to come. You come to me like sunshine down from above. Your beautiful eyes, like your beautiful eyes. Another day, another night has come my way, and there is one thing I just have to say. I feel so empty and so sad if you go. Like that, you come to me like sunshine. come to me like sunshine down from above. Pour some rain on me to wash away the dirt in my eyes, like your beautiful eyes, like your beautiful eyes, like your beautiful eyes, like your beautiful eyes. Oh yeah, thank you, thank you so much.
Ooh,
yeah. Yeah, I really hope that many of you heard that out there. That's beautiful, man.
Thank you.
I really
just like
that.
The title would suggest.
Yeah, what a voice. Yes. What a voice. I must admit, it's my first time hearing you live, and I'm impressed.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much. Beautiful Eyes, you said you wrote it in 2014, yes?
Yes.
So this was here in, not in Warsaw, it was in Bangkok.
Yeah, it was in Bangkok.
It was in Bangkok.
When we were visiting Warsaw,
uh-huh.
I decided to record some of the studio.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Very nice.
I uploaded it on YouTube.
Singer and composer. When you compose music, do you does it just hit you? Does a song come in your head and you say, wait a minute, I have to sit down, I have to write something.
Yeah.
Don't talk to me.
Yeah, it's like that. Okay. Like if I'm bored or something, or I feel upset.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So if I feel upset, it means sad song or something.
Sad song is gonna come out. So it comes from where you're feeling.
Okay.
Now, for a lot of artists, their songs, their poems, whatever form they're using to express, that tends to be like their real selves. Whereas when they're being social, they're not always themselves. Would you say this is kind of similar idea?
Yeah, kind of. Because like, I made a lot of mistakes before, since before I was a crazy guy or something.
Mm-hmm.
So I was recalling my history, or mm-hmm. I don't know how to say it, really. Something like that. So sometimes I will be, it's hard to think about it. Like if you're a Filipino, it's hard for you to go out to your country.
Really?
Yeah, it's very, very hard.
Why?
You need visas.
Why so?
I don't know, maybe because of the poverty or
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So everyone wanted to go out from the country and find some good future. Not in my country. Yeah, it's harder.
Yeah, there's some crazy things going on in the Philippines.
True.
Yeah, I'm reading. Well, at least it's coming to light now. It may have been there much longer than what we're seeing.
Well, it's always, I don't know, like media adding something. But
adding a little extra spice.
For me, I feel safe. No.
Okay.
Yeah, back in my country, like
you
my
feel
family.
Safe
yeah,
in past,
yeah.
I mean, in Philippines.
Yeah. Back in my country, I feel safe. My family is this. My neighbors, they're like, okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So, because what they're giving us in the media is another story. Wow.
Well, not all medias, but you know, it like to burn the fire to the other side, to burn the fire to the other side. So it's like. They wanted to fight them, like the government and the something like that. So
the government and the
opposition or
the
something.
The opposition.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay.
I think we should take a break in for a little while, maybe, and give Pastilan a little break here because he's been singing.
He was singing and talking.
Yeah. So maybe we'll take ourselves a little short break coming up in a moment or two. And we'll come back and ask you more, Pastilan, about your experiences here in Warsaw. So, DJ, what do you have for us today?
Pick a letter.
B.
B?
B as in boy.
B as in boy. Well, I'm thinking of, since yesterday happened to be the 44th anniversary of my favorite genre of music, I'm going to go ahead with a real classic song called the Beat Street Breakdown. You know it?
I think I do.
Uh-huh.
I was around for the birth of hip-hop, I can honestly say.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I can't believe I'm saying it live on the radio, but yes, I remember the birth of hip-hop. And let me just tell you, I was not impressed.
No?
We can talk about that later, though.
Uh-oh. Okay. Well, we're going with Beat Street Breakdown by the gentleman Grandmaster Melly Mel.
They had great names.
Yeah, like they that. Did. They yeah. had some very interesting ones. All right, so here we are on ME Radio.
Too, because you can't let the streets beat you. Well, a picture can express 1,000 words to describe all the beauty of life you give. And if the world was yours to do over, I know you'd paint a better place to live, where the colors would swirl and the boys and girls can grow in peace and harmony, and where murals stand on walls so grand as far as the eye are able to see. I never knew art till I saw your face, that there'll never be one to take your place. And every time you touch a spray paint can, Michelangelo's soul controls your hands. Then serenades of blue and red, and the beauty of the rainbow fills your head. Crescendo colors playing tune. Man, why oh why did you have to die so soon? Say one, two, three, four, and just let me know what you came here for. And just clap your hands, everybody, and let me know that I'm not alone. And if you knew my man when he was alive, scream it out and say, Ramon. Ashes and dust to dust, where the good die young is all thy must. Cause that life must live, death must die, and the tears shall fall from the living eye. Tell me who's gonna dream the impossible dream of the beautiful cities and the islands' dreams, when your works of art brought into being all that the ghetto stopped you from seeing. Still life urban masterpiece, your chain mark was written on chains and walls. A $1 million gift only God released, and yet you got killed for nothing at all. So after this, there'll be no more hard times, no more bad times, and no more. Change none of that bull, just movies, museums, and the Hall of Fame. So all you hip hops, get on up and let's take it to the top, where we belong. Cause the age of the Beat Street wave is here. Everybody, let's sing along. Look, come on, say ho, ho. Say ho, ho. And to let me know I'm rocking the microphone, everybody say remote. In the sand, and the headlines say, man destroys man. Extra, extra, read all the bad news on the wall of peace that everybody will lose. The rise and fall of the last great empire, the sound of the whole world caught on fire, the ruthless struggle, the desperate gamble, the game that left the whole world in shambles, the cheats, the lies, the alibis, and the foolish attempt to conquer the skies, lost in space, and what is it worth? Huh? The president just forgot about Earth, spending all time being, and maybe even trading, the cost of weapons ran in the zillions. Like mice in the houses, even make the ghetto look nice. Huh? The water tastes funny, it's forever too sunny, and they work all night and don't make no money. A fight for power, a nuclear shower, a people shout out in the darkest hour. The sight's unseen and voices unheard, and finally the bomb gets the last word. Christian killed Muslims and German killed Jews, and everybody's bodies are used and abused. Huh? Minds are poisoned and souls are polluted. Superiority complex is deep-rooted.
All right. Hi, everybody. I'm recording myself. Yeah. That's my wife's hand. Pastilan's here in the studio. Pastilan is going to do another song for us called Traveler.
Traveler.
As soon as we are done with our, what do you call it? Music break, I guess. So stick with us, get a chance, log in. Look, I see DJ is logged in to see us. Log in soon, because Pastilan's going to perform live for us.
All right.
And I'll switch it around, yeah? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. There you go.
Arrah. That was Grandmaster Melly Mel, Beat Street Breakdown. You are live, and we are live as well on Emmy Radio.
Yes,
and we have our guest, Pastilan Jay, in the studio. And we decided he wants to open up this next break. So we are shifting things around just a little bit as we're getting ready to provide some more beautiful music all the way from the Philippines.
This is going to be very, very nice. I'm going to move over to the other microphone.
Do it. I dare you.
There we are. This is going to be very, very nice. What we have coming up for you now is a song called Traveler, and it's by Pastilan Jay.
Oh, yeah.
Had a chance to fix the wrong to right. Maybe I will be the man sitting at your side. If I ever had a chance to love you like my queen, maybe I will be the man to lift you up when you're down. And now it's too late to step back. We need to move on and never come back. I'm a traveler in this world, the world that we live in. I know I can't go back to what I've done. I keep traveling in this world, the world that I live in. I wanna change my name and make a new beginning. Make aliens, make it. Never simple to be a man on his own. And now it's too late to step back. We need to move on and never come back. I'm a traveler in this world, the world that we live in. I know I can't go back.
Wow. Wow, that was great. That was great. Now, what would you say is the inspiration behind that song?
Sorry.
I asked too soon. Almost there. Almost there.
Yeah.
Now, what would you say is the inspiration behind that song?
It's like to fix your mistakes. You cannot go back. You can go back to fix it, but it wouldn't be the same as before. What was happening before?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because you cannot go back to your problems.
Actually, it's pretty funny when you think about it. Life is all about mistakes and trying to learn from them. Yeah. And for certain people, you express them in some form. You put in some kind of physical, tangible way or audible way for people to listen and maybe not follow the same mistakes, right?
Yes, exactly.
Interesting, interesting. All right. Now, you've been in Warsaw for how long?
More than a month.
More than a month. Okay. And your little bit of experience, what would you say are some differences between Warsaw and Bangkok / Philippines?
Well, Philippines is a very crowded place. Mm. If you say Manila, very crowded. And traffic, heavy traffic. And yeah. Kind of Bangkok, it's also like crowded, but the thing is the competition there for musicians, like English musicians singing in English, it's not really they don't really have a lot there.
Oh,
compared
really?
To the Philippines. Yeah, Philippines, like a lot of competition, a lot of bands
in Bangkok.
Okay. No, I mean in the Philippines. In Bangkok they have a lot, but they have more locals.
Okay.
More locals.
Okay.
Than foreigners who sings English. So, Warsaw, the difference is here, the music is really different. The bars, they don't really have live music. They mostly bars, only few bars. So, for me, that's the difference. And here also, it's quite the street. There are like only few cars. Or something, yeah,
yeah.
That's surprising and quiet. Yeah, no motorbikes. Yeah,
no motorbikes. The perspective is interesting because I come from New Orleans, mm-hmm. Louisiana, and I come to Warsaw and I say the traffic is horrible here.
Yeah,
really? That's cute.
So see, yeah.
So how much more in Asia? Just think about it.
That's great.
That's pretty cute though for you to say the traffic's bad here.
Yeah.
You've never had to deal with Dallas stuff.
There
was just always construction, especially in the north side of Dallas, close enough to my house.
Where is Dallas?
Texas.
Oh, that's right. Okay.
Lord.
We'll move on.
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing. Texas mm-hmm. is a wonderful, wonderful state.
Yeah, it's the best country ever.
Best country ever. And I think if Mexico would like it back, we will sell it to them.
We can ourselves.
Compared to Dallas, traffic in New Orleans is nothing.
It's cute.
Yeah. Houston, too, I'm told, is a nightmare.
Let's not get into Houston, though.
Yeah. So you came to Warsaw a month ago and you're here looking to do performances and sing.
Yes. Yeah.
And we thank you for coming in and singing live for us today, as a matter of fact. At the Gitlet Festival on last
Thursday.
August 10th, what songs did you do there?
I was singing the Tagalog song, Tayo'y Magkatula, it's called.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, Tayo'y Magkatula is like, we're the same.
We're the same,
yeah.
Okay.
Have the same feelings that a couple separated.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So they're both sad.
Uh-huh.
Sad, yeah.
That's very interesting. Like, and because I really like the idea of what you just said, how we're all the same. Yeah, three of us in this studio are from three different places. Well, it's five of us in this studio from five different places.
Yeah.
But everybody can relate to your music,
mm-hmm.
right? It's the same feeling. Since What are some of your impressions about, let's say, the people of Poland?
Well, the people of Poland, they're Polish, yeah, what I mean. I like them because they're polite.
Uh-huh.
And like straight. Yeah, if they don't like you, they don't.
Straight talking.
Yeah, mm. and if you're nice, it means they're nice to you also, yeah. So it's, they don't really like pretending.
Uh-huh.
Yeah,
uh-huh.
Not the same like back in Asia. Like they will smile at you,
mm-hmm.
but you don't know what's behind
those smiles.
Those smiles, yeah. Maybe uh-huh. they like you, maybe they don't.
You yeah. never know.
Yeah, yeah. That's why I like Polish, because they're pretty straight.
Yeah, straightforward people. I would agree. Yeah. Actually, that's been kind of my experience as well here.
Yeah.
What do you do in your spare time, Pastilan?
For now,
his wife like, is yeah, saying like, something. Like, right now,
she's whispering.
Well, for now, like thinking about looking for gigs or something, or like a recording company to record my album or something. Yeah.
Kind of. So you would like to get it? You would like to find a studio here and actually record your album.
Yeah,
and you have the music to do it. If we have any record producers listening out there,
any listeners, studio owners, record producers, anybody connected to studios, let us know. We'll pass it on to Pastilan Jay
for sure. Send us a message on Facebook, or we've also posted Pastilan's contact information on our webpage with your Twitter address. And your Facebook fan page.
Okay.
So there's all kinds of ways to contact.
Yes. Yes, exactly. Actually, I wanted to know, where did you come up with the name Pastilan Jay?
Pastilan means it's fuck off or something, yeah, but the Google.
wait, I gotta go back. Did I hear what I thought I heard?
No, it's like expression on what you feel.
Uh-huh.
If you feel angry,
mm-hmm.
very, very angry, or firing, like burning, or if you feel blessed. It's like opposite. You, if you feel blessed, if you feel mad, if you feel crazy, like. Yeah, it's like Pastilan. It depends on how you express your feelings. Like,
uh-huh.
if you're so happy, Pastilan, thank you so much. Yeah.
yeah. Okay.
I don't know how to say it in English. So
it's, I translate.
Yeah.
It's like, oh shit.
It's like between
or
bad
like
or
bitch
bad.
For people.
Yeah.
Or what?
Or a bitch for people.
A bitch for people.
Yeah, because like I would call my friends bitch. Like,
yeah,
what you doing, bitch?
Yeah.
You know, like,
you
as a joke.
Your friends bitches?
Sometimes,
yeah.
Wow. Where are you from?
Texas.
That's why, like, she was Googling it. It's like, oh, this one is the, like, terrific. I was like, really? It's kind of something bad, something good.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah,
so it
like,
covers all the bases.
Yeah.
So it's like, bitches, oh, shit.
Damn.
In Polish, the word can I say it?
Oh,
yeah,
the station? Probably.
On the station. That word? Yeah, I don't speak Polish, but I can say that word, can I?
Yeah. Right. That is a very flexible word.
It's a very
flexible that's why,
word.
Yeah.
It's like ours are fuck.
Yeah, it's what?
Yeah.
Fuck. That
yeah.
one.
Yeah.
We just
say
exploring all the words here. F-U-C-K.
Yeah.
F-U-C-H.
Back in Bangkok, some American guy, but I don't know where exactly from American, is like, oh man, you sing like mother, yeah, something like that. Yeah, it means very good, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
But I understand, yeah.
Okay.
It's like, yeah.
You sing like a Pastilan.
Yeah, kind of, yeah.
Okay. All right, now I get it. So that's why if I Google translated it, something strange probably will come up. Okay. All right, now.
So
I
it's
get
like,
it.
Jay, you're Jay, yeah?
You're the shit. Yeah.
Yeah. You're Pastilan Jay.
Pastilan Jay, you mother.
Real quick, we can do our little English section right now. English
dun, dun, dun,
section.
Dun.
There are a bunch of words like what they call contronyms. You know what these are?
No, tell
Contronyms
me.
Contronyms are words that have, let's say, two definitions, and they mean the opposite of each other.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So. Kind of, yeah, that's the one. Pastilan
Jay. Yeah, that's an excellent, that's so, an excellent discussion.
One example would be to cleave. It's either to join or adhere closely, or to split or divide.
I love it.
Okay.
So Pastilan is a contronym.
Yeah.
I suppose so.
Sweet. Like sweet. No, sweet's not a contronym. Yeah. Bitch is a contronym.
It can be, yeah.
It can be.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Interesting.
So that's our word for the week, ladies and gentlemen. Contronyms. And Pastilan is a contronym, we think.
How you spell it?
Contronym?
Counter name. Counter name, yeah?
Yeah.
C-O-N-T-R-A?
I would put a Y-M.
Y-M.
Yeah. Okay.
So.
Okay.
C-O-N-T-R-O-N-Y-M.
Okay.
Contronym.
Oh, contronym. Okay.
Who are some of the musicians you respect?
Musicians I respect.
Musicians you respect, and they could be dead or alive.
Well, I used to sing a lot of, like, 80s rock.
A lot of 80s rock?
Yeah, 80s rock. Like Bon Jovi, Guns N' Roses, or something like that.
Okay.
Or the classic one, James Brown.
You
I
love James?
Yeah, I like James. I think good. Yeah, yeah.
Would you play that on your guitar?
I used to, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I used to. That's my favorite one, I Feel Good.
Mm-hmm.
And the other very classic one, Stand By Me, the original one.
Stand.
That by me.
Yeah, that wasn't James. That was somebody else, wasn't it?
No, not James.
In general, he meant.
Oh, the song. That
he would play.
Okay, that's, from that genre.
Yeah,
the
melody of the song is like punching me. Like,
yeah.
Very. Yeah.
There. I gotta share this because I'm sitting here laughing to myself, and I don't know if it's gonna come across as funny or not. But here we go.
Uh-oh.
We did this improvisation one time where we were interviewing James Brown,
mm-hmm.
but James Brown had to have an interpreter next to him. So the person would say, "So James, tell us about your life," and James would say, "Huh? Wow!" And then his interpreter would say, "James says he feels great."
That's a very long one.
It's funny, nice. Man. You can take questions from the audience. So, James, how did you come up with this song?
Did you get up and dance too?
Soul master.
Yeah, nice. Man. That's right. So James Brown, classic Eddie Rocks. Any singers, songwriters you appreciate today?
Today?
From today's world of modern whatever's?
Bruno Mars. Yeah, Bruno
okay.
Mars. Yeah.
Yeah.
Amazing guy.
He's really short, isn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is he?
Yeah.
I think he's like Tom Cruise short. Like here.
Like not that meter, short. No,
like a meter high.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah, I saw him not live, but performing on TV, and like the guitar was close to his height.
When you do the guitar like that.
Yeah. Like that, exactly.
Bruno, are you listening?
I hope he's not listening.
If you are, come by the studio next week.
Yeah.
You said you also did covers, or you probably still do, but what sort of things would you cover?
Yeah, I cover like a lot of alternative rock,
mm-hmm.
and because it depends which bar I was playing. Yeah, and mostly if like Asians,
mm-hmm.
I would play. Number one is like All of Me, John Legend. Uh-huh. Like John Legend, that's like yeah, I like that song so much.
Okay.
Like, so, yeah. Sometimes I feel like crying when I sing it.
Ooh.
Yeah, but you know, on the stage, I wouldn't do it like. Yeah. But maybe in the room, in my mm-hmm. room, like I feel like.
Or
that's,
as a
that's
closer.
How I sing. Yeah, yeah,
mm-hmm.
yeah.
Did have you been writing recently?
No.
Is it because you think you're in a new place or?
Yeah. Exactly. It's hard, like.
Get your bearings and figure it out.
Okay.
Figure out the scene.
I think we're going to take another short break. What do you think, DJ?
All right. We're going to jump back to hip-hop, and I figured...
he's on a hip-hop mode.
I figured this one's very fitting for the season, what's left of it. And so I decided to put on some Fresh Prince of Jazzy Jeff. And you know what song I'm thinking.
I know what song he's going to play now.
So on Emmy Radio, we have Summertime coming up.
Yes, indeed.
Summertime. It's late in the day and I ain't been on the court yet. Hustle to the mall to get me a short set. Yeah, I got on sneaks, but I need a new pair. Cause basketball courts in the summer got girls there. The temperature's about 88. Hop in the water plug, just for old time's sake. Break to your crib, change your clothes once more. Cause you're invited to a barbecue to start at 4. Sitting with your friends as y'all reminisce about the days growing up and the first person you kiss. And as I think back, makes me wonder how the smell from a grill can spark off nostalgia. All the kids playing out front, little boys messing around with the girls playing double dutch. While the DJ spinning a tune as the old folks dance at your family reunion. Then 6 o'clock rolls around, you just finished wiping your car down. It's time to cruise, so you go to the summertime hangout. It looks like a car show. Everybody come looking real fine, fresh from the barbershop or fly from the beauty salon. Every moment frontin' and maxin', chillin' in the car, they spend all day waxin', leanin' to the side, but you can't speed through, 2 miles an hour, so everybody sees you. There's an air of love and of happiness, and this is the Fresh Prince's new definition of summer madness.
That was Summertime by DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince, a.k.a. Will Smith. For those of you who surprisingly did not know that he rapped.
People really didn't know
that he
rapped?
There were quite a few people around here that are like, why does he look like Will Smith? I was like, dude.
Wow. Yeah, he's been in the business so long.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Yeah,
so funny.
I kind of remember him as a rapper and Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
I also remember some kids, Vanessa was teaching these youngins, and she was showing them Michael Jackson. And I think the question was, why is he black? So it's like, geez, he didn't know about his Jackson 5 early solo days.
When he had the Afro and the African nose. Long gone, yeah. We're back in the studio with Pastilan Jay, everybody. He's going to do another song for us because we are coming close to our end, unfortunately. Today, time does go very, very quickly. What's the name of this song for us, Pastilan?
It's in Filipino, song called Tayo Magkatulad.
Tayo Magkatulad.
Tayo Magkatulad.
Can you tell us what it's about before you start jumping into it?
It's like a couple separated, they live in a long distance relationship.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay.
A couple separating and having a long distance relationship.
And were any of your songs based on personal experiences, or were you observing people, or are you allowed to say such things at the moment?
No.
That's the short answer, okay? Tell me again the name of the song, Pastilan.
Tayo'y Magkatulad.
Oh, I was going to try to spell it, but I won't.
It's like T-A-Y-O-Y space M-A-G.
Never mind. It's trying to spell it in another language.
Okay.
I'll just we are the same.
It's like we're the same.
And here we go.
Isipin ko na lang na nandito ka, malayo ko para mayakap kita. Alam kong masakit ang lumayo sa'yo, ikay sigaw pa rin ng puso ko. Pasensyahan mo na lang ang aking pagkukulang. Ganyan lang siguro ang mabuhay.
Thank you, Pastilan. That was Pastilan Jay, everyone. And there was somebody outside of our window here at the studio that passed and stopped and looked.
You're getting new fans already.
Getting new fans all the time.
Was it a bacha?
Yeah. We should put speakers outside.
That's the next step. The next step.
We're coming to a close of our show today, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to go off the air in approximately 3 or 4 minutes. But before we go, one more question for our Pastilan. What keeps you here?
What keeps me here?
What keeps you in Warsaw?
He's my wife, yeah.
His wife?
Wife keeps me. So does she keep you, like, locked up in the room? Or?
Not really. No.
Play for your freedom.
No, she's the one who...
So how hungry are you? Yeah. Music. I want music.
So she's the who came up with the idea to come to Warsaw?
Us, yeah. Her, she wanted to go back, and I wanted to go with her also. Yeah.
Good, good. That's good. And you two have been together for how long?
7 years.
7 years.
Yeah. Wow, long time. Yeah. Same with my wife. We've been together 7 years.
And we got married. We got married last February. Yeah. February. Yeah.
Nice. Congratulations.
Yeah. You got married where?
In Bangkok.
In Bangkok. Mm-hmm. Very nice.
Would you say, was your wedding more on the traditional side, or are there anything that's different than what you may normally see for, like, I don't know, American weddings on TV? Or?
Well, what we did there, it's only like papers.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Just the legal part.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
Stamp.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because we don't have families there.
True.
It's far to come here, and visas are hard on my side. So, like, okay, this one.
Nice.
A quick 10 minutes ceremony.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Efficient.
So, sir, thank you again for coming in and being our guest today. And if you're listening out there, everyone, this is Pastilan Jay. He is a singer and composer that is now living in Warsaw. If you would like to send him a message or speak with him about, I don't know, music maybe, you can write us on Facebook, or you can look for his contact information on our Facebook page. He also has a Facebook fan page, yes?
Pastilan Jay.
Fan page, Instagram, Twitter, anything like that?
On YouTube, Pastilan TV.
Uh-huh.
Facebook, Pastilan Jay, or Thin Jay. And Twitter, Pastilan Jay.
Very
WordPress,
nice.
Pastilan Jay, WordPress, yeah.
Pastilan Jay all around. Cool, cool.
Yeah, we'll make sure to put it under this video too, so you'll have all of it. Thanks again, sir, for coming in. DJ, next week we have another special guest, yes?
Yes, his name is Francesco Chiarini. I managed to practice on that name.
Francesco Chiarini.
Yes, yes. And funny enough, he's playing tonight, but with his bossa nova jazz.
I heard about this. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Where is that tonight?
Bovar. I'm not entirely sure. It's near the Copernicus Center,
I believe. The new Bovar.
Yes, the new Bovar. Nova Bovar. That was part of the important address there. Yes. So Francesco Chiarini with his bossa nova jazz. I believe Ritmo Affinato is the name of the band. There will be a Nova Bovar tonight.
Thank you, DJ. Again, thank you, Pastilan. This is Virgil Smith. We're signing off from What Keeps You Here. Join us again next week, or you can listen to our rebroadcast on YouTube that will be coming up, Monday or Tuesday. We don't like to set deadlines. It's not good. We don't like that type of stuff. Maybe we should. I don't know.
We'll work on it. So, goodbye, everybody. Listen to the IMI Radio.
Cabo. Chamo ngay to lang. Maulun wala aksan.